those who are raising their hands. Of course, we would like to formally welcome Ms. Saisa Cruz-Bacani as a part of XPPH. So may we call on our division head and assistant to president, Mr. Takuya Maeda, our division manager, Mr. Nelson Perez, our chief marketing for digital camera, Ms. Marie De La Cruz, and our ex-ambassador, Mr. Romel Bundalian.
Again, a round of applause for Saisa Bacani.
Session with Ms. Saisa Cruz-Bacani later. So now the floor is open for some questions from our ex-PPH.
Do you shoot the black and white direct from your people?
We shoot black and white direct.
Do you use a black and white mode in your X2? Your camera or you
color
edit?
Right now my X20 is in black and white mode because but in Hong Kong I use color. Practical akong tao eh. I don't want to lose the choice of color or black and white.
So you choose you shoot in RAW?
Yes, I shoot in RAW and some, these photos are in JPEG actually because my Lightroom doesn't have. Is lumang-luma na. It can't.
Wala na. So, she uses X20 for
that. Paano mo nababalansa yung work at passion mo sa photography? Kasi, alam ko, yung sa employment mo, meron kang employer na, ano siya, nakakaintindi ba dito sa ginagawa mo? Pinibigyan ka ba ng konting flexibility para ma-indulge mo rin yung passion?
My employer is very supportive, but we have this kind of agreement that work is work. So if I'm working, I'm working. If I'm not working, I can shoot. Maybe ang kinaganda lang ng photography sa akin is the more na napapagod ako, the more na naiinis ako or nagagalit ako or kung ano man yung mararamdaman ko, the more I shoot. It's my way of releasing all the stress na nakukuha ko sa work. And that's how I balance it, siguro. And I don't sleep. Yes.
Hong Kong people are known for they value their privacy a lot, and they can be very prickly when you pierce it, no? So in any situation, like when you shoot and when they complain, hey, wait a minute, you know, don't shoot me or something like that. You know, how do you deal with situations like this when they confront you and say, no, please don't?
When they ask me to delete their photo, I delete the photo because it's their right, it's their privacy. That's why you need to be a fly in the wall. You don't need to be noticed. One time, an old lady tried to hit me with a payong, and an Indian guy tried to get my camera from me. So if they want me to delete the photo, I delete the photo. But most of the time, because I try to blend with the surrounding, I look like a Chinese, they say. And I have an earphone palagi. So pag may nagreklamo, kunwari kahit narinig ko, wala akong narinig. Kakaway lang ako, parang ganon. Then I walk out. Pero kapag talagang ito confront ka, it's their karapatan nila yon. So we need to delete the photo. Kumbaga respeto sa kanila. Sayang, pero wala tayo pagawa. Anything else? Okay na?
How did you start your journey sa street photography? Paano ka nag-umpisa?
Okay. I posted a photo of a guy, a beggar actually, because I have no idea what street photography means, in a group. And then that group was like, oh, why are you, bakit mo sinushoot yan, ganyan. They were angry. I was like, huh, nangyari? Parang galit sila sa akin kasi nag-post ako ng ganon. That's why I keep on telling people to be nice. Kasi imbes na maka-inspire ka, nade-destroy mo yung interest ng tao na mag-join ng street photography because you're being an asshole. Pero if you explain to that person na, ay, kasi sa street photography, you're not supposed to shoot this or do that, maybe yung taong yun ipupursue yung interest niya. So there was this group then, I posted that one, then, ayun, na in-etchos nila ako. And then, nakita ko ng ano, ni Kuya Ten yata yun, ni Kuya Nick. Nakita niya ako then, he asked me to join the group of Daan. And they were so very nice people. They welcomed me and they taught me all the things that I know. So thank you, Daan.
Daan people.
Yeah. Yeah, very supportive.
Tanong na pinapatanong din nahihiya si Ricky. At tanong na rin namin, how did you first come to be noticed? Or what was the first photo that got you to where you are now?
It was the photo, I joined National Geographic Hong Kong Photo Contest year 2012. And one of my photos became a finalist. That's the first time na na-notice yung photo ko. It was just parang katuwaan. So, not Geo Hong Kong. That was the first time. And then, na-addict ako kasali ng contest. Actually, people should join because doon mo malalaman eh kung may quality yung photos mo or wala. Pero kahit wala, basta masaya ka, shoot lang. Yan.
Do you have any more questions?
Yeah. Hello.